Hello everyone, my name is Nick Lusardi.
And I'm Hannah Tracy.
And we'd like to introduce you to our newest passion project.
Newest addition to the family.
It's called
Hometown.
Our baby.
Hometown is a series of short stories told from various perspectives from many of our characters in previous films, including the Loons.
The film introduces two new members of Andy's family, who we haven't met before, and reintroduces two old characters of his family from one of my first, really my first independent short film, Tootsie Roll, his two sisters.
So, Hometown was a difficult project for us because it involved a lot of time and effort.
And people.
We had to stitch together many of these stories in such a light that they stood like on their own in their individuality as like soul stories, but stitched together like with a sense of community. And I think that you'll see that portrayed throughout the film. Hometown was definitely something near and dear to us because it involved our friends. We filmed it in our hometown, you know, all these stories are interconnected. It could be anybody. So while these themes are portrayed by us in a light that, you know, we wrote it as, these are just our personal takes.
While the characters and events are fictional in the movie, the themes are not, and we wanted to bring to light a lot of things that have followed us around throughout our young adult lives here in our hometown, and we wanted to involve as many people who cared about those issues as we possibly could to create something that gave a new perspective on these issues. The people that we loved made this movie happen in a place that we loved, in a place that we grew up. And that being said, it's not meant to pander, exhaust, or offend anybody. It's just meant to show it how we see it.
Thank you to everybody who was involved and everybody who acted, filmed, directed, held the boom, created art.
Let us use their property.
Yeah.
Or didn't let us use their property.
Participated
willingly or unknowingly.
We'd just really like to thank everybody for being a part of it, and we hope you enjoy.
Now, without further ado, please enjoy our newest film, Hometown.
Hometown.
Jinx.
To Sammy, you're the only one who will most understand this wasn't anyone's fault but my own. I'm sorry for leaving such a mess. Just with everything. I know it was really hard for us. It's been really hard for me to keep everyone together, and I don't think that it really matters anymore. Max is gonna leave town, but he'll come back. Please come home for Holly. You need to keep her away from Dad. He's gotten a lot worse. And I need you to be there to explain to people why I chose such a fucking messy way of doing. Just tell them at that point it didn't matter. Please. I love you.
Let me in! Max! Let me in!
What the fuck is going on? What the fuck did he do?
You may hype it up pretty good.
Yeah, okay.
I never heard, like, I'm excited.
Okay.
No, 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 no move another piece. I don't know how they work very well.
Okay, so I'm going to point something out.
Okay.
So this, that was a smart...
That's where I wasn't going to move.
No, but that's a smart move, though.
Why?
Because if I took this and put my knight there... Your queen could come and take my knight.
Oh! All I know about chess
so
is
this...
from that one pop song that was like... A king can only move his face at a time. The queen's a pretty
girl. It's a great song.
You know, that's the extent of my chess knowledge. I am a baller, an absolute baller at checkers, though.
Oh, okay.
I go up to Soup and Country. This particular Soup and Country was on top of a mountain, right?
Okay.
And I'm up in it's the Himalayan Mountains, so I'm up there, and they've got their big restaurant, their big red neon sign, and I go in there, and with Soups and Company, you get to eat your soup with a company.
When the fuck were you in the Himalayan Mountains?
Like, last week.
Damn, okay.
But then I hear, hey, I'm like, what? And it's the comatose patient next to me, and he's like, I'm not in comatose. I'm like, what? Like, they've been keeping me here. They've been using me. I've got them, and you know, keep in mind this is on top of the Himalayan mountains. So Soups and Company guards they pull out their nines and their blickies.
Yeah, they're knives.
No, they're nines.
Nines? I thought you said knives.
No, they're nines. They're nines. Blickies. They're ops. So they start shooting at us.
How many profits are you getting from a dude going all day? Come on now.
Oh, he was like a skateboard, like a big boogie
no,
board.
No. You said you did what to him?
I rode him. Ninjas on either side of me throwing their stars. We're dodging them. And there's a husky sled that we land on top of. And we fly down and we slam down into the canyon. But before we even make it down, we land on the cherry red wings of a World War II biplane. And I'm like, what? It's my old friend Yuri. Yuri goes, I think you guys needed to live.
You're telling me the Soups and Company restaurant has old people, that is your company, and borderline like dead people. And people in comatose that they're using for profit.
From what I gathered, yeah.
From what you gathered, this is all just an assumption?
Well, no, it's off of like personal experience.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. This is clearly like an Indonesian flight.
No, it's not.
Look at it.
How do you know that's Indonesia?
Now, he's in the bouncy house.
He's not in a bouncy house. They're fucking dead. They're on fire.
He's dead.
Okay, I'm gonna. Jesus fuck. Good luck finding shit. is that?
What?
Person over by the tree.
What?
Who the fuck is that?
I don't know who the fuck that is.
Alright, so who is this person?
This is Eugene.
You fucking daft? Dude, this is... I'm not talking about this person. I'm talking about the
just
person we were fucking arguing about.
Just talk to him. He's right here.
Okay. I'm
shut
fucking
your mouth.
Sorry.
Shut your mouth.
Okay.
First off, my name is not Eugene. My name is you. And if you want the information that I have for you, then you better shut your mouth. And remember, my name is you.
All right.
You got it?
Yeah. Yep.
All right. So, first things first, Brat is crazy. Okay? Brat's mental. I swear she's probably fresh out of the asylum. If I'm a book honest with you. Now, on the side, you know, me and Brat, we, you know, we know each other. We go back a little ways. You know what I'm saying?
I'm just gonna cut you off here and just like I just want to know who the fuck she is. I don't care about whatever you guys are doing.
Wait a minute.
Okay.
Yeah. Can I get a number two? Yeah, and I'll do honey mustard with it. Can you make it spicy? Thank you, appreciate it. Yeah, I'll do a Dr. Pepper for the drink. Oh, wait a minute. My fault. I forgot. I had a mobile order. I got two fucking idiots on the phone with me. My fault. Yeah, the number 6823. You got it? I appreciate it. Thank you so much. My fault. I didn't mean to screw up with your system or whatever. Yeah, actually, I think I could fuck up some Baconator fries right now, man. Can I add one of those on? Yeah, thank you. Yeah, perfect. Yeah, that'll be all. Yeah, thank you so much. Appreciate it. Yeah, I mean, like if you wanna, you can pull up. I mean, I'm not trying to drive anywhere.
Are you still ordering or what? What?
I'm talking to you. Okay. Hey, pull up.
Okay.
Yeah. She's like really fucking gross. And not in like the kinky way. Like in the fucking nasty way. Like beats her shit out of animals and probably like use their corpses as like a bong and shit. It's fuck.
Have you talked to her at all?
I haven't, but RJ has.
Yeah, she's a whore. I mean, a whore. She had intercourse with like 30 gentlemen.
Really? My sister's friend said that her stepdad fucked her.
It's just not right. It's not morally incomprehensible. It's...
That's freaking...
It's not okay.
Fricked up.
What?
She's ugly, too.
So are you guys, trying to, make a new friend? Or,
I say we watch and we understand, we come together and we draw a conclusion.
What the heck is she doing?
She's watching something, bro. One of the houses.
No way in hell she comes over here, right?
Oh, shit, boys. Is anyone going to talk to her? Kyle. Come on.
No.
Come on.
No, it's not happening.
Come on.
Don't. No. Kyle.
Fuck you.
You know what? You guys are some bitches.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Thank you.
What's up, baby?
What do you think?
He's not dead, that's the plush.
I've heard some things about her.
What'd she say? What the fuck's going on?
Okay, alright. There's gonna be a heist. I didn't hear all of it. There's something bad's gonna happen. Someone's gonna die.
Do we call someone? Someone's gonna die.
We are not calling anybody. We are handling like men right now, alright? So get in your car. Someone's gonna hear us. We gotta leave. Right now. Right now.
Alright,
I got a bunch of just like red more bombs.
I got out of town.
I got like five cemetery dogs there. So send a biological, dead sheep, spread diseases.
Stray dogs.
Stop. Listen, alright? We gotta figure out what she wants. So we're gonna go to her place after it's dark. We're gonna go through all of her shit. We're gonna figure out what like she's getting at here, alright?
Hell yeah!
Alright.
She's not there, let's go.
Books, cigarettes, pair of gloves.
What's that under the blanket?
Hope it's a Zen. Wonder, just knockies.
Alright, so there's the house. Ayo. What the fuck?
What is it?
Hey, let me see. You, check out.
What is it, man?
What is it?
Wait a minute.
What
wait a minute.
Wait a damn minute.
Weird.
Is it? Just tell us. What is it? Shut your mouth.
Bro, if you don't shut up, you can't see.
Okay.
I gotta go.
Hi, Max. It's this way. This apartment's for museum-sponsored guests, usually, so I'm not really supposed to keep you up here. You're gonna have to decide tonight which direction you're going. Do you get it?
You stay just for a minute.
check me. Sorry. I need to get going.
Mom used to tell us about that legend from where she was from. Do you remember? Do you remember? Is that the lantern of a lighthouse? It was not for ships, but for souls. It could bring people back. Do you remember that? Why aren't you wearing a coat?
I'm gonna kill myself tomorrow.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes.
You're not!
To a better place afterwards.
What if he doesn't?
I think it's his choice.
He
He's in checkmate. I don't have a choice.
Well, geez, it's just a game of chess. Just reset the board, play again. Max, I said, what's in the pack?
Nothing.
Do you have one of these?
No.
Let me show you something. Are you scared?
Yeah.
Are you still scared?
Less.
You know about lanterns. They hang out in lighthouses and give grace to lost ships. Lighthouses forgive. Lanterns are the source of their forgiveness.
That doesn't make sense.
I don't care.
Are you my mom?
No.
My mom's a loon, you know.
I really should get going. But hey, keep that thing. You'll need it. My dad's a heron, by the way.
She's right, Max. It wasn't your fault.
Max, you're my best friend, and I know you're gonna think a lot of things after this happens, but you need to know this wasn't your fault, okay? And there's a lot of reason for you to put the blame on yourself, and there's a lot of times where you probably thought you could have talked me out of it or something, but it wasn't that easy for me, and I'm sorry that it had to end up like this, but it's not on you, man. It's not on you. Okay, it was a lot of things I could control. I couldn't always control what was going on in my head, and I'm sorry. But you're my best friend in the whole world. You understood me like nobody else did. And I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but it wasn't your fault. Please don't blame yourself. Drive.
cover that old Ford. I miss it, Lord. I miss it, Lord.
Please leave your message.
Hey, Dad. I wanted to let you know that I'm not coming home. Fuck you.
I'm in love with a girl. She's intelligent and confident. She's a wonderful dancer, and she has the prettiest makeup, the prettiest hair of any girl I've ever seen. And with this hard, striking look in her eyes, it's like she was once a very elegant or beautiful woodland creature, or something from a fantasy, like a nymph or a mermaid. She's dated both boys and girls, I think, which is good for me, I guess. She used to date a nice girl from Hillman, and after that, a really nice boy from north of town. He killed himself, though. My dad said girls can't date girls, but I think Ellie is too beautiful to be a girl. She's magical. Nowadays, she's dating Mason Riffert, but everyone calls him the Snowman. The Snowman helps people out, like my family, by giving kids jobs. He gave me a job. Usually he goes all right, but if you mess up, he gets pretty angry. Today I'm helping the snowman out with some work. Maybe I'll get to see Ellie.
You understand I had to do this. This is the Western Hope. As you can see, she's very old, very rusty.
Right.
She was carrying cargo, ship, and grain.
She wrecked in the bay here. It was a terrible accident. Everyone died.
Oh!
It was a terrible accident.
Hi, Grace.
May we please borrow a sink?
Should we call someone?
No. No, thank you.
You can't smoke in here.
we gonna get caught?
No. No one saw me.
So now what?
Not sure.
Oh, what a sight. I can't decide what I like more. Yeah, your lips and your eyes. So take me inside. We'll make it a night. Wake up in the morning. I'll look in the floor. So sensual. I'm so sentimental. I'm looking for my sunset. But you gotta see me.
Yummy. You shouldn't smoke. Where'd you get those anyway?
My dad.
I'm more than this, you know. I wanna throw rocks in the lake and break stuff. Sit down.
I learned from the snowman that anything you did to survive was okay. I still don't know why Ellie liked him. She was pure, like mist.
You're a little young for me. Can I have one of those cigarettes?
we'll be here. Thanks.
Holly, you are going to do amazing things, and you are such an incredible artist, and such an incredible dancer, and such an amazing individual. I just always was so inspired by you, and you made a lot of things really nice. Please don't ever lose that part of you. And please stay away from the people that are going to break you down and destroy you. And don't do anything stupid like I did. Please. It's... You have so much life ahead of you, and there's so much you can learn from everyone else. Try not to end up like me, please.
Do you think the thing about the loons is true?
Which thing?
The thing about the dead people. If it were true, we'd be able to hear them now, even in the winter.
Do you hear anything right now?
Was there anything unusual about that winter?
Never snowed. Not once.
I'm talking about Andrew.
Oh, are you switching?
Why?
Wait.
But I got a weird blend. Silly, goofy.
Interesting. Like the thing we did in question man. I wonder if it's pointing at us or if it's just pointing up.
It's hard to tell with the lights.
Oh. Simba.
Hold on, I gotta do the thing.
Lick me.
Dude, you're gonna get sand in your eyes.
Did you receive a personal letter from Andrew?
I think we all did.
How do you think Max is taking this? Where's your other son? Where is your other son?
If I could do it again, I'd do something different.
And what would you do differently?
I don't know. What are you listening to?
What are you listening to?
What? Just feel
everything you said.
You lied after that.
We're leaving.
Sam, I have a letter for you.
Probably, yeah.
Okay. I love you.
I love you too.